Hi nerds, I'm Will Wheaton, and this is the quarterly box that I curated for the first quarter of 2015. You can see that I very cleverly removed my address label in order to protect privacy. So even though I curated everything that's in this box, and I theoretically know what's in this box, I am excited to open it because this has been sitting at my house for a couple of months now, waiting for me to record this particular unboxing video, and I do not know exactly what is inside. So let's open it up and we will find out together. All right, let's find out what I got from my curateds. Well, this is exciting. Look, it's a letter that I wrote, which you can probably see. This will very likely be on the internet someplace. All right, so every box that I'm doing this year is themed around a decade of my life. I'm 42 years old, so we've got a box from the 70s, 80s, 90s, and nows. The very first box is representative of all the things that I loved in the 80s, starting with trading cards. Looks like this little package of actual, authentic, vintage trading cards is Battlestar Galactica and Star Wars. It doesn't still smell like that bubble gum that you would make yourself chew because you felt like you were supposed to. This is rad. Droids in the Escape Pod, Han Solo, R2-D2, and then Starbucks Land Ram. Oh man, and it's got a Cylon poster thing on the back. That's awesome. I also included a Little Bits base kit. So this is sort of a modern take on the Radio Shack electronic project kits that I loved as a kid. So I would go to Radio Shack, kids, ask your parents, and I would just buy like all these little bits of electronics and stuff and then put them together into things like to make like a police scanner or an AM radio or a doorbell or a series of lights that would blink on and off according to a pattern that I set. I really love Little Bits because they give you all of these cool little integrated circuits and switches and things, and they're all joined together by these little magnetic connectors. And they're color-coded to tell you which type of element you're using as you assemble your project. There are tons of Little Bits project kits, and I own most of them, but I strangely do not own the base kit until now. Also, if you've never used Little Bits, you get one of these neat Little Bits gift cards that gives you $20 off any kit that you purchase. Oh, kids. Oh, kids. So it was really important to me to include an authentic vintage action figure from the 70s when we were putting this box together. And I really wanted to get Star Wars figures, right? I got an original authentic Chewbacca figure, so I can recreate that amazing scene from The Simpsons where Ralph Wiggum bends his Wookiee. This is exciting to me. And just like the actual action figures I had when I was a kid, the gun is missing, which is fantastic. Finally, the last thing that we included in this box is a poster for my podcast, Radio Free Burrito. The plan is to make a poster for each decade of Radio Free Burrito had it existed in the 70s, in the 80s, in the 90s, and then of course the nows. So this is our 70s style. You got the rainbow, you got the sort of like 70s-ish kind of font, hopefully when this is all done, if you get all four quarters, you'll be able to put these together into a little square poster, you know, in that Andy Warhol style. That is what is in the first quarterly box that I'm curating this year. Coming up next is a box from the 80s, and you can probably count on getting something directly related to console video games, and very likely something related to role-playing games, because those were two incredibly important influences on my life in the 1980s. So thanks for watching, and thanks for subscribing to my box. You can get it at quarterly.co/WIL. That's quarterly.co/Will. And play more games!